78 Sports TV here. Salute to the mighty LDBC. Smash the like button, hit the subscribe, turn on your notification bell so be notified when I drop a new video. And if you're digging the video, go ahead and share this joint. Well, Donald Trump, 45, has won again. He is now 47 and 45. So Donald Trump won again. Oh, it's not official yet, but it's basically for the last 2 hours has been headed that way. So I'm just going to do this video now, and I'll upload it once it's official. But right now, according to Fox News, they have been seem to have been the fastest people to call these states. CNN and MSNBC are taking forever to call the states. But according to Fox News and a few others, Donald Trump has 267 electoral votes, and Kamala Harris has 216. All Donald Trump needs is another three, and he will be president. He's going to win Alaska. That hasn't come in yet, so we know he's going to win Alaska. That's all he needs. And he's probably going to win Michigan. I don't know about Wisconsin. He might, but it's looking like he's en route to becoming the president once again. This has been a wake-up call, should be a wake-up call for the Democratic Party. They panicked once Joe Biden had that horrible debate, and they tried to throw Kamala Harris in there after dogging her for 2 years and telling everybody how horrible of a vice president she was. You then try to flip it and tell everybody what how great she was, and you've ignored your base for all this time, and people are tired of it. So let's look at some of these exit pollings. Let's check out some of these polls. Okay. This is likely voters. Black, we're going to break it down by race because everybody loves to blame everything on black men. They're saying, according to this poll, CBS, 80% of black men were going to vote for Kamala Harris, 19% for Trump. 92% of black women were going to vote for Kamala Harris, 7% for Trump. That's according to CBS, right? But there's a little, some slightly different numbers here. Now, this one here says male support for Harris. Among white men, it's 36%. Among Hispanic men, for Harris, is 53%. Among black men, is 72%. So I'm trying to, I'm having a hard time understanding why Obama and Michelle Obama, Barack and Michelle felt the need to come out publicly and chastise black men as if we're not Kamala Harris's second biggest voting bloc. See what I'm saying? So it's just ridiculous. Now let's look at some of these other polls here. Now, this is exit polls from the election. So, breaking down by gender, Kamala Harris, 43% of men, Trump, 54% of men. Kamala Harris wins 54% of women. Trump wins 54% of women. And that's overall women, okay? But Trump actually won white women by 55%, if you see that, okay? Now, you can see the rest of how everything's breaking down there. Let's take a look here. That's college graduates. You see the numbers there. Now, this is an interesting one. This is one from comparing 2016 Donald Trump versus Hillary Clinton to Donald Trump versus Joe Biden. Now, as you can see here, according to this, you have white women. Donald Trump won white women over Hillary Clinton by 52%. Then he won white women over Joe Biden by 55%, okay? Now, he's kept that when going against Kamala Harris, which is strange because the Democrats really pushed this abortion stuff, women's rights and all this stuff. They kept pushing that agenda when you got people who are struggling with the price of food, struggling to put food on the table and pay their bills, inflation. They're competing with illegal immigrants for housing and for jobs, right? People are concerned about their daughters competing against naturally born men in their sports and stuff like that. All these things are very important, but the Democratic Party refused to deal with and tackle with these issues. They tried to tell you what they felt like was important, which was women's reproductive rights, which in actuality, a lot of people are upset behind, Kamala Harris, you know, Kamala Harris cannot come in as a president and change women's reproductive rights. She can't overrule the Supreme Court. All she can do is wait for somebody to croak or something and then, you know, put somebody in position on the Supreme Court to maybe overturn it in the future. But she can't wave a magic wand and fix none of that. Right now, abortion is up to the hands of the states. And that's the way Donald Trump wanted it anyway. Look at some more. I got any more polls? I think that's it. Let me see here. Oh, this was a CNN poll. All right, but anyway, long story short, you know, Trump won despite the fact that the Democratic Party had pushed this. They made him a legend. They made him a myth. They made him notorious. They charged him with all these felonies and stuff like that, and you made him a hero. And then you didn't lock him up. He just kept getting out, kept walking free. You turned him into the Teflon Don, right? That's what y'all did. Y'all built this man into some type of legend, okay? And you thought people were going to be able to relate to him. Listen, politics has changed. The world has changed. You know, people are not drawn to what they used to be drawn to. You used to be able to destroy somebody's character with all this little slanderous stuff that y'all normally do. But now it seems like this is doing nothing but helping these guys. So the Democratic Party has a lot of waking up to do. They have to realize that Van Jones, D.L. Hughley, Steve Harvey, and Cardi B, and Meg Thee Stallion, these people don't speak for the black community. Okay? They don't. Right? Black people are tired of being chastised and talked down to. And I think the Democratic Party, if you're serious about getting more people out to vote, what you need to do is start right now. Come with the agenda right now. Start right now. Don't wait until 3 years from now to come around telling us who to vote for and what we need to do, because y'all haven't done that to white women. Y'all haven't done that to Hispanic women. You haven't done it to white men. You haven't done it to Hispanic men. Even Asian women is siding with Donald Trump. Now, make that make sense. By the numbers, y'all see the charts. Asian women are siding with Trump. White women side with Trump. The only people that's really riding with Kamala Harris is the black folks. Black women and black men, by the numbers. Yes, there are 20-some percent of black men that did not vote for Kamala Harris. So what? Still 70-some percent of them did. That's still her second biggest voting bloc. And if you're not going to criticize everybody else, you shouldn't be criticizing black men or trying to guilt trip black men into voting for one party who clearly don't want to do nothing for us anyway. Okay? So now, what's going to change for black folks? Nothing. Donald Trump has already been the president. Ain't nothing for the change for us, whether Trump is the president or Harris. Okay? So it is what it is. Kamala Harris' campaign came out and told everybody to go home. She's going to address the crowd tomorrow. That was basically a concession right then and there when she did that. Donald Trump told his people he's coming out to speak. So we're waiting on that. Y'all let me know what y'all think. I'll be back with some more information about this. We're going to be talking about this on my boxing show. 78 Sports TV, salute to the mighty ODBC. Smash that like button, hit the subscribe, turn your notification bell so you'll be notified when I drop a new video. And I'm about to hit up. Deuces.